As one of the highest paid copywriters in the world, I receive about $15,000 to $25,000 per sales letter. And I got a few tricks up my sleeve on how you can attain clients that pay that kind of moolah. Hi, my name is Kenneth Yu. Welcome to Write Your Own Damn Check, where you learn the strategies to seize control of your financial destiny using just the power of words and persuasion. If you like more of this sort of content, please like, click the bell or subscribe. Now, low-paying gigs really suck, right? Lots of man hours and little reward. You try to service your client and you still get blamed for their failures. It's just really, really frustrating, isn't it? So the cool thing, right, is that if you're able to get higher paid clients, they usually end up dream clients as well. Because a business owner that sees you as an investment rather than a liability, rather than a savior, creates a whole different dynamic. It's actually a lot more enjoyable to work with clients that pay you what you're worth, and to appreciate the work you do so that, you know, the grind becomes a little bit easier. And so here's three ways, or more rather, here's four ways that you can do that. Number one, you need to identify clients that are not startups. You need to identify clients that are not startups. Startups are exciting to work with, but they don't usually, one, have a lot of bandwidth to offer you. That means they can't afford you, for one. Number two, whatever little they have, if they put in you, they're asking for a lot because it's all they have. You can't blame them anyway. But it creates a hellhole for you. Because now you have to deliver expectations that are impossible to meet because they're in a startup phase. Like, a lot of things go wrong in the startup phase. And you're getting paid peanuts for really trying to do your best work. So try to find clients that are not startups. Try to find clients that are already making 7 figures or 8 figures or 9 figures. Like some of the friends I know, I know a friend who runs a very successful supplements company, and he pays his copywriters anywhere from $15,000 to $25,000 for a single sales letter. And the reason for that is because he sees writers as an investment. He does not see them as a lifeline. Do you see that difference? So if they see you as an investment and not as a liability that they have to hire you because it's in their budget and they desperately need someone to sell their stuff, and oftentimes it's what people don't need because startups are still trying to figure out their offer, or would you rather just be someone who's like, okay, I'm paying you. If you make me money, great. If you don't, we moved on. No hard feelings. And no, you know, being on the phone and just being the client's like support, like lifeline. Like, oh, I'm drowning. And there's nothing you can do. So identify clients that are not startups. Number two, you need clients that have existing infrastructure for success. You need clients that have existing infrastructure for success. So what do I mean by that? It means that copywriting success isn't just about copywriting. It's not. There's a lot of different things that need to go right for a blockbuster campaign to occur. And it's everything from making sure the technology setup is right, the offer has an audience to begin with, the staff members are actually doing their jobs. Google and Facebook doesn't suddenly come up with a new update that disrupts everything. Like, it's just a lot. And you need to have clients. And if they're not startups, they will have that level of infrastructure. Because if they're startups, they may not have any of those things. Which means even if you throw copywriting in and your copywriting is brilliant, it might be pearls before swine. Because they don't have the support to leverage your persuasion and your results. And let me give you an example. And this isn't even a startup. This is a company that's actually successful. It is reputed to be the strongest bank in the world. But they didn't have the infrastructure to support my efforts. So what I did for them was I did SEO. I know it's not a copywriting example, but it's a service example. I did SEO for them, did it really well. They were number one for keywords like banking and credit cards, loans at number two, which you know is nearly impossible, but I did it because I had a proprietary SEO strategy at that time. And their leads doubled. So pretty much their online leads doubled on the strength of the organic campaign. But unfortunately, they still let us go. They still let us go at the end of that quarter, even though we delivered the results. Why? It was because no one followed up with their leads. They did not have the infrastructure, the sales team allocated to them. I mean, they have sales teams, just not to the online lead portion. And all the leads were wasted. They were just in an Excel sheet and that was it. Isn't that insane? And because of that, they blamed us. They were like, you're not generating sales. But we were like, we're not supposed to generate sales. Your team is supposed to generate sales. And they were too lazy, or more rather misallocated, to talk. Isn't that crazy, right? So you need clients with an existing infrastructure, very important. Number three, you need a track record of delivering those kinds of results, meaning the results that you have done over the years must paint a picture that you are trustworthy and that you, whatever you deliver, can get that result. And it's not 100% guaranteed all the time because sometimes, even to our best of ability, the success rate at a mastery level is about 40%. So you can imagine how brutal it is. I mean, even LeBron James have a lot of off games, right? Like the greatest NBA player of his generation only has what? Four titles, four world titles in 15 years. So it's not easy. But you need at least that four titles, as it were. And how you get those titles is you, by hook or by crook, go to a client and make them successful. And if you're new, what you do is you work for a client for free or you do it really cheap so that you can get those results. So when I was starting out, I did copy for cheap. And those copy delivered results, I got more and more work because of those results. So it becomes a snowball. Now, no one even looks at my portfolio. Now, they are like, all right, we know you by reputation. We want you. When are you available? Cool, right? So that's what you need to do to attract these kinds of clients. Number four, you need eyeballs on that track record as much as possible. You need eyeballs on those results as much as possible, which basically means you need to shout that result from the mountaintop. You need to put it in your social media. You need to put it in your website. You need to put it in your resume. You need to put it on your portfolio. So what will really impress your client is that if you have a copywriting portfolio, let's say you have sales letters, emails, if you give them the stats and you give them the results of that portfolio. So if you wrote a video sales letter for, let's say, a client, you can say, oh, this VSL converted at 3%. Or this VSL delivered $1 million in sales, let's say. And the minute you're able to quantify it, life becomes so much easier and everyone wants to work with you. Just embed your results in everything you do. And so, are you ready to attract high-paying copywriting clients? Again, let me reiterate. Number one, you need to identify clients that are not startups. Number two, you need clients that have existing infrastructure. Number three, you need a track record of delivering those results. Number four, you need eyeballs on those results as much as possible. And so when you do that, that's when you can start going to a new echelon in your copywriting journey and when you can start commanding really, really great life-changing fees as well. And if you want further insight, strategies, frameworks on how you can do that, on how you can write copy that attract these kinds of clients, I have a free 5-day training. It's hosted on a Facebook group. I do it sporadically once every few months so I can train up the next level of copywriters. And it's totally complimentary. I'm not asking for anything. In fact, every single one of the exercises, if you do them on the wall, like basically it's a Facebook group, you do it in the comment section, we will critique each and every one of those exercises. Me and my team will actually do that. And it's really fun. It's like a festival of learning, festival of persuasion. So come join me and it will be in the link below. It will be in the description section. And it's called Knights of the Holy Grail. And I hope that you will join me so you will learn how to attract these kinds of high-paying clients. And so if you like more of this sort of content, again, remember to like, click the bell, subscribe, comment below even if this has helped you. And I wish you all the best. And I wish you WYODC.